I can't hear that in my earphones. Hello, I'm Narelle Summers, emotional well-being coach and speaker. Good morning or good afternoon or good evening, whether you're listening to this on catch up or live, or you're in a different country, because we're based here in sunny UK. Can you believe that? Do you want to feel happier throughout your day? Do you want to feel more relaxed throughout your day? Do you want to feel more positive? Then stay tuned, because I'm going to be sharing some tips and techniques on how to do that today. And as always, in the studio, I'm joined by Richard Harrison, the owner and producer of my programme and of Smile Radio. Hello, Richard. How are you?
Great to be alive.
I love that saying, absolutely love it. And if you have any questions throughout the show, if you're listening to this or watching it on Facebook, you can pop them in the comment box, or you can email richard@smileradio.co. Come along and say hi. If you're listening to it on Facebook or watching it on Facebook, you know, give us a thumbs up, show us some love. I'd love to know who's watching today. So first of all, we're going to kick off with a song, like always, with Justin Balmer, with Fix You, featuring Blake.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. When you get what you want, but not what you need. When you feel so tired, but you can't see. Stuck in reverse. Lights will guide you home and ignite your hope.
absolutely love that song. I think she's got such a beautiful, beautiful voice. She's actually a friend of my sister-in-law's. So if you want to hear more of her music, Justine Balmer, and she's got a Facebook page, and she's also got a web site to go and have a look, and a YouTube channel as well under her name. So go and check her out. But yes, today we're looking at different things to make you feel happier, more relaxed, more positive. And the reason why I do this monthly radio program is for people to have a better quality of life. I go on courses, I go on workshops, I go on events, because I want a better quality of life as well. And I'll tell you a bit about my story in a minute. But all the information that I learn on these courses and events and workshops, I want to pass on to people, because I know you can have a better quality of life, because I've actually changed my life. I was heavily overweight. I was really unhappy. I was very miserable. I spent a lot of time in tears, mainly because I was overweight. And not knowing how to deal with the stress and anxiety and the frustration of life, what that life throws at you. You know, my two best friends were the cupboard and the fridge. And I went on the courses and the workshops and the events because I wanted a better quality life. I went and I learned, and what I learned, I implemented into my life. And I changed my body and I changed my mind. I've maintained my weight now for nearly 6 years. That has never happened in my adult life. I've just recently had my anniversary of 7 years without alcohol. I no longer turn to food and alcohol when I'm stressed and anxious or frustrated. And yes, I'm going to, you know, tell you that, because I don't lead a perfect life. I still get stressed. I still get anxious. I still get overwhelmed. I've just been through, you know, a global pandemic, just like everybody else. I'm going through the menopause now. And I tell you now, that in itself is a journey and a half. Things happen to me. But the thing is, I've got my little toolbox of the things that I have learned on these courses, these workshops, these events that I use on myself on a daily basis, that I pass on to my clients and I pass on to my audiences, my listeners of this radio program, and, you know, people who attend my keynote. And that is what it's about. You know, it's about taking time out for yourself and look after yourself. And also, what I didn't realise years ago was that the mind and the body are connected. So it is about looking after your mind, but it's also looking after your body as well. They come as a package. And there's one thing that really helps you to calm down and relax both the mind and the body, and that is being mindful, being present. And that means not thinking about something what's just happened in the past, not, you know, thinking about things that have happened in the future. Because when you start to think about your past and your future, you know, negative feelings start to creep up. You know, the worry, the anxiety. And that, you know, will have an impact on both your mind and your body. I can remember several times watching a television programme and turning to the person who sat next to me saying, hold on, how come that woman has just got in that car with that man? I thought they weren't talking to each other. And they've looked at me and said, you've just been sat in watching that in front of that television, Narelle, and you've just been taking it in. And that's because I completely zoned out. So I could be physically present in the living room, but not present within the mind. I could have been thinking about what had happened that morning, what was going to happen tomorrow, not being present. And I've actually been in situations before where people have been talking to me face to face, and all of a sudden they've said, and what do you think about that, Narelle? And you know what? I haven't got a clue what they have just said, because I've just completely zoned out. And I've just actually looked at Richard, and he's there smiling. So he knows exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I do that occasionally.
But that's because you're not present. Mm. and you've completely zoned out and you're completely thinking about something else. And also, as I said, it's draining. But once you are being present, it will re-energize you. It will refocus you. And you'll be present and you'll be connected with the people that you're talking to. Now, mindfulness walks. How many times have you had a walk and you've just been completely zoned out and you haven't noticed things? You've walked past things. For example, you know, maybe a house for sale, and then somebody said, oh, that house has been up for sale for weeks, and you've gone, what? I've never noticed that. Go out for a walk for 10 or 15 minutes and really take in your surroundings. Take in the trees, the plants, the buildings. Just really be present. And especially if you're working, take a break, take a lunch break, go out for a 10 or 15 minute walk. Some people think, oh, I've got to get this done. So they'll work through the breaks, and it's tiring and you're not looking after yourself. If you took a break and went for a walk, you would be a lot calmer. You'd be more focused. You'd be more creative and more energized to continue with your work. Go outside, refresh yourself, enjoy the time you spend outside. Also, mindfulness drinking, and I'm not talking about alcohol here. You see, Richard, eyes just lit up then. I'm talking about, well, maybe not in the next couple of days in the UK because we're here for a serious heat wave, but hold your cup of hot drink in your hand. You know, breathe in the aroma of your drink. Feel the warmth of the cup around your hands. Look at the colour of your drink. Be present. I'll tell you what I do in my office when I have a tea break. I've got a big chair sat near the window. I have my Red Bush tea with my oat milk. You see, Richard's laughing now. And
I'm sorry, I'm such a child. It's Red Bush.
Red Bush, yeah, and Red Bush tea. There was a builder on our street doing some work who I know, and the people were on holiday. And I went up to him and said, oh, do you want a drink? And then I forgot that I didn't have cow's milk in and I didn't have coffee in. And I said, you know, and he said, oh, yeah, anything will do, anything will do. I said, well, it'll have to be Red Bush tea with oat milk. He went, yeah, yeah, fine. Apparently, there's other people on the street now making him drinks, so we don't need me to make him a drink anymore. It is a unique taste. But going back to me sitting on my big chair with my Red Bush tea in my hand, and what I've started to do now is actually look up at the sky and do some cloud gazing. They're just mesmerizing how they move and how fluffy the clouds are. I mean, you hear about people doing stargazing, looking up at nighttime and looking up at the stars. I mean, they're beautiful, and watching the shooting stars. They are beautiful. You're in the moment. You know, you can take yourself outside and just sit there for a moment with a drink and look up and do some cloud gazing and just look at them gently moving and the fluffiness of them. It's about being in the moment, being present. Also, mindfulness eating. How many people eat not at a table? Eat with the TV on, eat with the radio on, or eat with their phone on, they're playing on their phone. How many people do that? You are not in the present moment. You know, sit at a table, switch the TV off. I'm going to say this, but switch the radio off. Leave your phone on the side or in another room. I don't have my phone at the table. It's in another room. No distractions. Have a look at the different colours on your plate. Smell the different aromas on your plate. Put some food in your mouth and then put your knife and fork down and slowly enjoy the taste of the food. Be in the present moment. Now, sometimes it's difficult when you're at work, but make sure you're away from your workstation to enjoy your food. And enjoy it and be present. No phones. Enjoy it. And also, make sure that you are choosing healthier options. You know, good food does equal good mood. Now, I know if I've been out and about, if I've been on holiday or I've been in hotels and I've had food that is not healthy, the next day I will have a food hangover. I'll feel sluggish. I may have a bit of a headache. I might feel sick. I've got a hangover because it's not been healthy. So be aware of what you're actually putting in your mind. Not in your mind, in your body, but it will help your mind. Something that I discovered in one of the lockdown, well, lockdown one actually, was mindfulness colouring in. I absolutely love it. I got some colouring in books from the internet. I got some felt tip pens and off I went for an hour, 2 hours. It was an escape. I really enjoyed it. It brought back happy memories of my childhood. I used to do it as a little girl. And it was just amazing. And now I actually know some GPs that when people are actually going with anxiety, that they are actually recommending mindfulness colouring in to their patients. It's just a great way of doing it. And, you know, you can print off things. There's plenty of websites where you can print off mindfulness colouring in, so you don't have to go out and get books. It's about enjoyment of being present. All those worries and the stress just floats away, okay? So whatever mindfulness exercise you choose to do, it's all about being present in the moment. Not thinking about something in the past, not thinking about something what's going to happen in the future. Being present. And that goes for when you are on your own and when you're with others as well. Because it's important to make that connection with others. If you're not present with a person, they'll know about it. And there's one big thing about not being present with other people, and that is your phone. You know, stop looking at it. Put it in your bag. Turn it off. You know, connect with that person. People need a good listening to. They like to be listened to. Don't listen to reply or to respond or to tell your stories. Listen to be present. Let them finish it. Because if you don't, then they'll change the subject and they'll come back to it. Be present in that conversation. They will really appreciate it. Now, I can think of one thing in particular. I once went to a party quite a few years ago. And I was talking to somebody and I was asking them about their job. I didn't know them. It was the first time I'd met them. And I came away from them and I thought, I know everything about them. But you know what? They hadn't asked me any questions. I hadn't told them anything. They didn't know what I did. And that person ended up being a client because they felt that I'd really listened to them. They'd obviously Googled me. They found me on Facebook. And they became a client because I respected them. I gave them space to talk. People do like that. And also, with your phones, I'm going to say this now. So stop using your phones when you're actually with people. But be aware of using your phones when you're on your own. They are like rabbit holes. It can suck up your time. Even if you say, just go and check something, you know, half an hour later, you're still on your phone. Is that true, Richard?
Very much. I'm terrible at it sometimes.
And I turn my phone off at night time, and I actually turn my phone off sometimes on a weekend as well to give myself a break. Do you ever turn your phone off, Richard?
No. When it's done an update, maybe. Sorry.
No, no. You see, people don't turn the phones off. People actually use them as alarms, so they don't turn them off. Don't give themselves a break. It's really important. I know some people have got that app that have that time limit. And after a certain time, they can't use their social media anymore. I can't remember what app it is. But yeah. there's time limits on there. So just be aware of that. When you're with other people, make sure you're not on your phone. I mean, I've recently been on holiday and I've been with a friend. And I was abroad. I didn't buy a mobile package. So I was actually using Wi-Fi. And as soon as I got on Wi-Fi, I was on my phone. And there was a couple of times I just said, I'm really sorry. I'm going to put my phone away. That's not acceptable. I'm not present. And she went, oh, no, it's okay. It's okay. But it's not okay. You need to be present with people because that's how you build relationships and you build connection.
There's a word that I have always picked up on when people say, oh, it's fine, or I'm fine. That means that they're not. And I say it to the kids all the time when they say, you're all right. Yeah, I'm fine. It's fine. It's okay. It's fine. Actually, it's not.
Yeah.
That word fine is not. It's not good. So I always say, it's not fine, it's good. Anyway, it's my input.
Thank you, Richard. No,
observation.
No, that was great. Because I think fine is a mask, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's underlying. There's underlying things.
It's not what you said, it's how you said it. Sorry.
No, it's okay. Right, there's a story... to this next song I'm going to play. My friend, Mark Folan, he was recording songs throughout the lockdowns. And he's got a beautiful voice. I really like it. And I actually I sent him a message saying, oh, are you doing requests? And he said, no, I'm not really. But what song do you want? And I'll have a go for you. I said, I really like the song from James Blunt, Bonfire Heart. And he said, I'll have a go. And bless him, he learnt it and he recorded it. And this is the original recording he did in his in the lockdown, in his living room of Bonfire Heart. Bless him. And also the song has so many really happy memories because it reminds me of Date with Destiny with Tony Robbins. So in a lockdown, when you're on your own, somebody's actually stepped up, learnt the song for you, recorded it, and tagged you in the post. Bless him. Thank you so much, Mark. This is for you.
Your mouth is a revolver, my bullet's in the sky. Your love is like a soldier, loyal till you die. I've been looking at the stars for a long, long time, pointing out
people like us, we don't need that much, just someone that starts the spark in our bonfire hearts. Days like these lead to nights like this, lead to love like ours.
Love that song, and thank you so much, Mark, for doing that song for me. It really did uplift me in the lockdown. So, you know, it was just fantastic. Now, Mark Folan does have a Facebook page, Mark Folan Music. His email address is markfolandz@aol.com. He's also a fantastic actor as well. He's been on Coronation Street, he's been on Emmerdale, Scott and Bailey, Hollyoaks. Go and check him out. He is just a beautiful, beautiful soul, is Mark. Thank you. And yeah, the thing that I wanted, why I wanted to play that song today, because it did lift me in the lockdown, you know, and use of music really does change people's moods. Now, I've got an actual playlist on my phone of music that brings back happy memories. And if I feel like I need a little bit of pick-me-up, I play those songs. I may dance and I may sing in my office. I obviously won't do that today. I'm actually tone deaf. I love singing. Absolutely love it. But yeah, I'm tone deaf. But playing music that's attached to happy memories, as I said, that song is attached to Date with Destiny with Tony Robbins, and there's so many fantastic memories attached to that. So, you know, when you feel that you want a little bit of a pick-me-up, listen to a song that has happy memories attached to it, you know, and if you can, dance around, sing. It really does change that. And also, what changes your mood as well is photographs. You know, have a look. Everybody keeps their photographs now on the phones. I keep saying, stay away from your phones, but sit down and have a look at your photographs of happy memories. You know, the photographs and the music have happy feelings attached to them. So when you listen to the music, when you look at those photographs, those happy memories come back and make you feel good about yourself. So do, you know, do that next time. Also, you know, have music in your car. If you're going for an interview or you've got a meeting coming up that's making you nervous, play some music in your car that's going to uplift you, you know. Or if you've come away from a meeting and you're feeling a bit deflated, again, put some music in your car and lift that up. Also, what I saw somebody put the other day, about photographs. If somebody puts something really nice about you on social media or sends you a really nice message on your phone, take a screenshot. And when you're feeling a little bit low and you want a little bit of a pick-me-up, have a look at those, put them in a folder and have a look at those really nice comments that people have made. And Richard was smiling then.
Yeah, it is music and, like you said, pictures just take to a point in time, good and bad. But the thing is, one of the things that I love about music is the fact it takes you to a point in time where, you know, like we played a song last night at the bar, Smile Barn and Venue, if anybody's in Huddersfield. We had a live act on, and afterwards, and then Insomnia by Faithless. It's one of my favourite tracks. The girls actually got me a picture, and the actual link, if you scan the phone, it takes you to the Spotify
right
track, yeah, which is really nice. But yeah, that came on last night, and it always lifts me up, takes me back to a time which is, you know, happy times, good times.
Yeah, it's powerful, isn't it?
Yeah.
I really like it. But I do like that suggestion that somebody made, you know, do a screenshot of all the nice comments that people have made about you, and it really will lift you. Also, something that really can alter your mood is the social media that you're actually looking at, okay? And what I would do, I would tell you to go and clean up your social media today. I mean, I do it on a regular basis. Anybody who posts anything negative, anything that makes you feel negative, unfriend them, unfollow them, block them, leave their groups. You need to see positive things on your feed. You know, people flick through and instantly you can come across a post that could change your mood in an instant. So what I say to you, and I have done it many a time and I still do it, I will unfriend people, I'll unfollow, I will block, I will just I'll remove myself from groups, because I don't want my mood to change when I go on social media. I don't want it to be affected. I want to see positive posts. So what I suggest to you today is you go and have a look at your social media, and anything that you think that is negative or brings up negative feelings, remove them. Clean up your social media. Also, something else that really does affect people's moods is the news. I mean, I would say, I don't know because I don't watch it, but 95% negative, or maybe 100% negative. I actually know somebody, and there's probably people listening to this as well, that set their alarm to the news. The first thing they listen to, first thing on a morning, is the news. I know people who watch the news on the TV the last thing at night. That's the last thing they watch, is the news, then go to bed. Now, I turned up at an airport a couple of weeks ago, and I was a little bit early. And I said, oh, I'm a little bit early. Can I check in? And they said, people have been checking in for the past 8 hours. Have you not seen it on the news? And I went, no. So the thing is that, you know, I think the news scares people.
Mm.
And it only reports on really negative things. I mean, you know, here in the UK, we're going to have a heat wave in the next couple of days. And there's so many warnings, apparently, on the news. I was talking to somebody, they stopped me whilst I was jogging, because they said, oh, be careful at the beginning of the week. Don't be coming out running at the beginning of the week.
What is that? Because you're strawberry blonde, is that what it is?
I'm auburn.
Fair-skinned.
I'm fair-skinned. And I said, oh, I probably won't, you know, or even, I don't know. I don't know what the temperature is going to be first thing in the morning, but I will see. If it's cool, I might still go out jogging. I don't know. But, you know, even she was saying that the scaremongering people now. And, so, and the thing is, it's really strange, because I don't watch the news, yet I find out about the news.
Mm.
You know, I have conversations with people, like that woman who stopped me this morning to say, be careful while out jogging. You know, friends will say something. I might see the odd thing on, you know, social media. So I don't physically sit down and watch the news. I don't physically listen to the news. when it comes, if I am listening to the radio in my car, because I normally have an audio book in, but if I do listen to music in my car, when the news comes on, I just turn it off. I'll put my audio book on. I don't listen to it. But I still get to know about things. Yeah, so I don't, yeah. So if you feel that you need to have a look at the news, I would limit yourself and only look at certain stories. Because there's so much going on now, and people scaring people, like, you know, queuing at an airport 8 hours before your flight is due. Yeah, it's just scaremongering. Anyway, I'm going to play another song now. And this song was sent to me by Francesca Waite, a friend of mine. And the band is called The Hell Hounds, and it's called I'll Remember You. The Yell Hounds, and they've also got a Facebook page, and you can find them on Spotify and SoundCloud. Okay, something that I just want to go back to about we talked about music and photographs bringing happy memories to you. There's one thing that I like to do, and I do tell my clients this, especially if they associate maybe a colour with a happy memory, or if you know, if you go on holiday or something like this, or you go to an event that brings back happy memories, buy something. And it could be a really simple thing, like a key ring, or you know, the colour yellow might indicate relaxation to you, or blue might associate confidence with you. And what I tell people is go out and buy things. Now, I know that some of my clients have actually gone out and bought jewellery with like a blue stone, or a red bracelet, or they've had ribbons attached to their bags or something. Something that represents those happy memories and those happy feelings. Now, when I go away, I always buy myself a key ring. And I've also got myself a water bottle. And so as you can see, if you're watching this on Facebook Live, there's my water bottle. That's where I've been on holiday. I've been to Canada.
Oh, well, you mentioned it a couple of times. Not that I'm bitter. I've lived in about 4 or 5 years.
So, yeah, so I buy things, buy souvenirs, and, you know, obviously, I'm a typical tourist. But the thing is, when I look at my bottle and when I look at my key ring, it instantly takes me back to my memories. So, you know, next time you go to an event or you go away, just buy some. Even it might be a pebble or a shell from the beach. And you can have that on your desk. Or, you know, in your bag, you don't have to buy any money, you know, or it could be a colour that you represent happy memories to. So, yeah, and when you do that, when you buy something, it's called an anchor. You've anchored those happy memories into that object or that colour. So when you look at that object or you look at that colour, it instantly brings back those happy memories, and it's called anchoring. And I absolutely love it. Also, what's really important, okay, we feed our bodies 3 times a day. Some people may feed them maybe 4 or 5 times a day. So why do we not feed our mind every day? That's a question that I want you to think about. If we fed our minds the same amount of times that we feed our body, we would feel absolutely fantastic. Now, whether that is reading an audiobook or watching videos, you need to be feeding your mind every single day, just like you feed your body. And the thing is, sometimes people go, oh, you know, don't have time. There's something called NET, which means no extra time. So no extra time is needed throughout the day, because that is the biggest excuse people always say. I don't have time. I don't have time to feed my mind. I don't have time to exercise. I don't have time to do this. I don't have time. There's no need, because there's no extra time involved in this. Because you can listen to audiobooks in your car. You can listen to audiobooks whilst you're cleaning. You can even listen to audiobooks whilst you're in the bath or shower. You can listen to videos, you know, whilst you're driving, whilst you're cleaning, whilst you're in the bath. No extra time is needed. And you're feeding your mind whilst you're doing another activity. So no extra time is needed, but you're feeding your mind. Now, have a go at this. You know, have a go at feeding your mind. You might start off with 5 minutes a day. Feed your mind, 10 minutes a day, build it up, 15, 20, half an hour. Feed your mind. And it doesn't have to be on personal development. If you're interested, if your subject is, for example, I don't know, history or Spanish, it's about your mind learning new things. It's about you growing as a person. If you're not growing, you're stuck. You need to be growing and you need to be feeding. And that is it. It's feeding your mind with information and knowledge. If you didn't feed your body, you would starve. First of all, you'd start having, you know, I don't know, stomach pains. You'd feel dizzy, you know, and then you collapse. So you need food to feed your body. But guess what? You need food to feed your mind. You need to be feeding your mind on a daily basis with information, with knowledge. And as I said, it doesn't have to be personal development. It could be, you know, anything. So start today. Have a go at feeding your mind for 5 minutes today and see how you feel. And then build on that. Also, something that really changes your mood, and I really don't think we do enough of this as adults, and that is laugh. I love to laugh. I love to laugh. Richard's smiling. I love to laugh and cry with laughter and even have stomachache with laughter. I love a good laugh. It's brilliant.
Do you like comedies?
I love comedies. I love comedians. I love going to, you know, see live comedians. I love laughing. I love it. So, and as I said, I think as adults, we lose that ability. So I want you to think of things. What makes you laugh? What makes you laugh, Richard? Yeah, I know you go somewhere else, and probably other people might go somewhere else. And that's because I'm a redhead. No, but it makes you laugh.
Yeah.
So have a think about what makes you laugh. Is it comedians, you know? Is it a certain film? Is it people? You know, certain people, I just think, oh, I'm really looking forward to seeing that person today. Yeah. Because I don't know whether I've mentioned this, but I've recently been away. And, Lindsay, my very, very, very beautiful friend, I am not kidding you. We howled. It was just amazing. And it was just amazing being with her. And we laughed at so much. It was just brilliant. So, you know, do more. What makes you laugh? Have a think about what makes you laugh and then do more of it. If it's, you know, go to see live comedians, go and book yourself, go and see live comedians. You might want to watch, you know, films that make you laugh, or even comedians, you know, on YouTube or Netflix or whatever. Whatever you do, go and do it. Because as I said, I love laughing, but also I do love making people laugh as well. And if I know that I can make people laugh, I do it more. It's just infectious. I actually did, in the third lockdown in the UK, I thought to myself, I want to do something. I want to do something for me. What can I do? And I wanted to lift my mood as well. And I actually did a qualification in laughter yoga, and it was absolutely brilliant. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. And I've done it for friends, and I've done it for a small groups as well, just to laughter is infectious.
It's funny you should mention that, because we've got a comedy night at Smile Barn and Venue in Huddersfield on the 29th of September, and we've got four comedians coming on, and I think a couple of them have even appeared at the Apollo, live at the Apollo. So yeah, if you want to find out any more events that are going on, we've got one coming up next Saturday as well. Go to smilebarandvenue.co.uk and all the events are on there. Sorry, Noel.
No, it's okay. And also, Silky is one of the comedians. What date is it, the comedian?
29th of September.
29th of September. Yeah, so I actually know Silky. I actually put him in touch with you guys. And yeah, it's just brilliant. Going to see live comedy is just hilarious. When you laugh, you release endorphins. And that will make you feel happier. You know, it makes you feel relaxed and calm afterwards. It lowers your stress hormone, the cortisol in your body. And it boosts your immune system. It can also lower your blood pressure. It just makes you feel better. So go and do something today. You can even just have a laugh yourself. Go and watch something and have a chuckle. It's just brilliant. You know, do something today. Whether that is the mindfulness that you could do today, have a look at, you know, your playlist. What music are you going to play in the future? Have a look. Get that ready. Because, you know, life will throw things at us. We are on a roller coaster. It's called life. Things are going to happen to you. You know, things are going to happen to me. But it's about having your little toolkit in front of you, with your little things that you can turn to. And what I say to everybody, what I say to my clients and my listeners and my audiences, you do what is right for you. You know what works. You know, have a go at things. If you think, no, that didn't work, have a go at something else. Find what is right for you. That's really, really important. Have things in your toolkit. That's for you to delve in when you're on that little bit of a dip of a roller coaster. And guess what? Very soon you'll be coming up and you'll feel great again. So I just want to just quickly go through the things that I actually do. So I am qualified in NLP, which is neuro-linguistic programming. That's what you think about. That's how you feel. Has an effect on how you know. When you have a thought, it will generate a feeling, and that will have a knock-on effect with your actions. For example, if somebody has a fear of flying, you might feel anxious about it. Therefore, you may not go on holiday abroad because you've got that block. So that, you know, NLP is also about the language we use and the stories we tell ourselves, the photographs that we keep in our minds of past traumas as well. So I work with clients on a one-to-one basis via Zoom in NLP. I'm also qualified in Havening, which is a psychosensory therapy that uses touch and visualization to remove negative feelings attached to negative memories. Self-havening is a part of Havening, so people can actually do it themselves over Zoom. I'm also qualified in goal mapping. I'm a goal mapping coach, and that is an online program, so that is done by Zoom as well. And that is the left-hand side of the brain is where all the words are, where your logic is. The right-hand side of the brain is where all the pictures are, the creativity, your imagination. So it's an online program using words and pictures to engage the whole of your brain to make your goals more focused. I love all my work I do on a one-to-one basis. I love working with my clients. You know, my purpose, my why, is for people to have a better quality of life, because I know that they can. I've changed it. I have a better quality of life than ever before. So if I can do it, other people can do it. I also have my, because I thought to myself, it's great working one-to-ones with clients, But how can I reach a bigger audience? You know, how can I improve more people's lives? And that's when I wrote my Be Kind to Your Mind keynote, where I share about 8 and 9 different techniques for people to have a better quality of life, a better quality of life, especially in the workplace. The stress is on the increase now, and it's not going away. You know, people are taking time off because they're stressed. They're leaving the people behind, having to work harder, but also people are getting stressed as well within the workplace. So Be Kind to Your Mind, as I said, shares about 8 or 9 different techniques to help you reduce that stress, to gain that confidence, to gain that positivity, to gain that self-esteem. So if anybody, you know, wants to book me for a well-being speaker, have a look at my webpage. It's Narelle Summers or wellbeingatwork.live. I'm on Facebook and Instagram under Narelle Summers, and I'm also on LinkedIn. If you're stuck or you want to change, then I'm really happy to work with you. If you're feeling that something, you know, you need to let go of something for you to move forward, then get in touch. You've listened to this program, you know how I work, you know, I want people to have a better quality of life. So get in touch.
Yep. So your last song you're going to play before...
Is Nick Neblo, and it's a happy, positive song.
So don't forget, if you've missed this show or any other show, you can catch it again. Go to our website, smileradio.co/on-demand. And if you're not doing anything next weekend, get yourself down to Smile Bar and Venue. We've got a Fleetwood Mac tribute act, and the support act is Civic Green, 4 lads from Barnsley, an amazing talent. So get yourself down, have a brilliant rest of your weekend, and thanks for tuning in. Take care.
Hi there, would you be happy if you knew that there's someone there who doesn't care if all your clothes are new? Hey there, you might be 1,000 miles apart, where you can have a house, a boat, a spouse, it matters who you are. I'll live with no regret. Elephants never forget. I'm coloring a light that's turning bright. I'll live with no regret. But elephants never forget. I'm following a sign. The road is fine. Misunderstood. I try to get to know me instead of judgments. All I'd rather heard. I'll live with no regret. But elephants never forget. I'm coloring a light.